or make it come into the middle of the screen.
Text alignment.
Yes, align. What we will do, we will just click on the screen in the components. Now you can see the properties section over here. You come down, you can see align horizontal. Click on it, choose the center one. It comes to the center. Horizontally, it comes to the center. And if you want to make it vertically to the center, you have to choose the other property, align vertical, choose the center. Now it comes to the middle of the screen. Now, can we just change the background color of the button?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Azam, is your system up now? Is it working?
Ma'am, I'm just setting it up.
Okay, it's not yet loaded?
It's loaded, ma'am. I need to write the project name.
Okay, fine. Do it. Where is the label? Yes.
Ma'am.
Have you done?
Virtual app with.
It was.
Okay.
Abel, are you there?
Ma'am, is this right?
Okay, Zia, well done. Try to change the screen color also.
Ma'am, I changed into light gray.
Light gray, oh, okay, fine, great. And you know, if you want to change, if you want to add an image, you can do that also, okay?
Ma'am.
I will also change my button color. And I will make the font size bigger. I will give it as something like 20. And I can also change my shape of the button. I will give it as oval. Okay. Done? Azam, done?
Mama, I'm just making it to the center.
Okay. You know how to make it to the center, right?
I don't remember the...
You have to select the component, screen component. Screen. In the component section, you have to click on the screen.
Okay, ma'am.
And in the properties, when you come down, you can see align horizontal and align vertical.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. You have to take center for that.
Click both on of them?
Sorry?
Both of them?
Yeah, both of them. If you take center, it will just come exactly in the middle of the screen.
Okay, ma'am.
Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now that is screen one. That is the design part for screen one, what we have. Now what we will do is, have a look at my screen, okay? Come back to the Zoom Meet. Now, on top of it, can you see something called add screen button?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, click on that add screen. A new screen will come. A new screen name is shown in a pop-up window. Screen 2. You have to click OK. If you don't want to change the screen name, just click OK. Fine. Now what happened is a new screen is added. See, a new screen is added. Done? Now,
yes,
in this what we will add is, we will come down, go to media first. We will take the text-to-speech, which we have done in the previous class. We will take text-to-speech and put it on the screen. And since it is a non-visible component, it won't be displayed on the screen, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Now, again, come back to the palette. If you come down, you can see sensors. Click on the sensors, and in that, what we have is accelerometer sensor. Okay, you have to click it, drag it to the screen. Now again, this is another non-visible component. Okay, so we can't see that also in the screen. So our screen 2 will actually be blank now. Fine, let it be blank for the time being. Let it be blank. Now we have completed our design section. The app, we have designed it. We have completed the app design section. Now what we have to do, we have to write the code. Okay. So what we will do, before that, all of you try to connect your mobile phone with this.
Ma'am, when I do it, should I start from build or connect?
No, not build now. We haven't completed the code. Only after writing the code, we will build it, okay?
Ma'am, can you see what should I do again?
You have a mobile phone with you, Zia?
I have a mobile phone, but it's not Android.
We need an Android phone. Only then you will be able to verify it.
Ma'am, I got it.
Yes.
It's a blank.
Do you have an Android phone, Zia?
No, ma'am.
Without Android phone, you won't be able to verify it, dear. So what can we do? You can do the coding part now, okay? I will tell you how to do that. If you want to connect to your mobile phone, so how did you do it yesterday, Zia?
Yesterday, when we were connecting to... connecting the thing to the phone, my charge went off.
No, yesterday you tried to connect with iPhone?
No, ma'am. When I was doing that part, the charge went off. So I could not listen to the other part.
So today you don't have that phone with you? Okay. Okay, no problem. You know how to connect it, right? Once you have that mobile, you connect?
Ma'am, I don't know to connect.
Sorry?
I don't know to connect the thing.
You don't know how to connect? I will show you. Look at my screen. Can you see a connect button over here on the top?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you have to click on this. You will get AI companion. Okay? You have to select this AI companion. So a barcode will be shown here. Okay. Now, in your mobile phone, you have installed one app, right? MIT Companion app. So, using that app, you have to scan this code. Okay, when you scan this code, this screen, whatever we have designed, all that you can view it in your mobile phone. Okay, it's a simple process. Just click on connect, choose AI Companion, the barcode will come. And from your mobile phone, you have to open that app and scan this code. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, Azam, so can you see both the screen? Can you see screen 2 on your mobile phone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now let's do the coding part, okay? How to do the coding part? We will take the block section. We will click on blocks. Azam, you were not able to do it yesterday, right? We will do it today.
No.
Yeah, we will go to the blocks. So when you go to the blocks, now my screen 2 was open. So on your left side, you can see screen 2 only here, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So what I will do, I will go up. I will change the screen 2 to screen 1. Now my screen 1 will appear here in the block section.
Yes.
Now what do I have in the screen 1?
A brown color thing.
What is that? That is a button, right?
Yes, ma'am.
In screen 1, I have a button. So when you click on that button, you have all the functions of that button. Okay? You will get all the functions. Now, what I want is, when I click on that button, a new screen should open. Right? So what I will do,
ma'am,
I will take this event.
Ma'am, where would I get the blocks?
Wait. Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you were here, right? You have this screen now.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, on top of this, can you see my mouse pointer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, can you see blocks?
Yeah.
You click blocks, you will get a white area. This is your coding area. Yes. Now, On the left side, can you see built-in screen one, any component?
No, ma'am.
No?
Any component.
Have you seen the screen blocks?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you have on the left side, Azam? Do you have screen one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So in the screen one, what we have placed? We have placed one button, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So what we button click is an event. Okay, it is an event. So what we need is when you click on that button, click, just click on the button, you will get the function. Click on the first one, the first event handler, click on this. So this is the code what we need. Okay. Yes. Now what I want is, when you click on the button, we need to open screen 2, right? So go to control, in the built-in, click on control, then come down, you can see open another screen, screen name. Can you see this?
Where's control?
In built-in, in blocks, on the left side blocks, can you see control, a brown color thing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Click on that control. You will get all the properties or all the functionalities available in control. Come down. You can see this function. Okay. You can see this command. Open another screen, screen name. Did you see this?
Ma'am, is that right?
Yeah. You have to take it and connect it here. Okay. You have to give this command inside the function, click, dot click, button one dot click. Now, can you see an open area over here, screen name?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that is the input value what you should give for this command. Okay, this command requires one input value. And that input value means it should be a screen name, right?
Yes.
So how to give that screen name? You click on text.
Text and take and the printing.
Take it, join it here. And what is the name of our screen 2? It is screen 2 itself, right? I hope nobody changed that name. So you have to type that name here, screen 2. One thing what you should be careful here is, you should give the exact name of that screen. Only then this will work. Okay. Yes. Yes, Zia. Now, Azam, once you have done this, please connect it with your mobile and just tell me what is the output.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. So Zia, let's hear from Azam. What is the output?
Now, should I scan the QR code again?
Yes.
Okay.
Scan the QR code again, and then click on that button.
Ma'am, it's in the progress bar. After when it's
completed.
Then I'll tell when it's complete.
Yes. Once you have loaded it, no, please show it in your in the camera, towards camera. Your screen open?
Yes, ma'am. I got it.
Okay. Now click on that button. Let's see whether the screen 2 is getting open.
Yes, ma'am. It's opening.
Yes. Now when you click on that,